गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल बी डीलिंग विद ओरल ट्रांसफर, द प्रोविजन विच हैज बीन प्रोवाइडेड अंडर सेक्शन 9 ऑफ ट्रांसफर ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी एक्ट. नाउ बिफोर गोइंग टू द पर्टिकुलर प्रोविजन, इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर अस टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट इन जनरल इन एवरी केस द प्रॉपर्टी मे बी ट्रांसफर्ड बाय वे ऑफ राइटिंग और विदाउट राइटिंग एन इंस्ट्रूमेंट. इट मे बी कॉल्ड एज एन ओरल ट्रांसफर और अ ट्रांसफर बाय वे ऑफ राइटिंग. That is to say, one can transfer the property either by opting for an oral transfer or by way of a writing. But that is to say, when we talk about an oral transfer, what is important? The delivery of the possession is important. So whenever a property which is transferable orally, if delivery of the possession been handed over, then in that case the transfer in itself is complete. Let us see movable property and immovable property having less than rupees 100 value can be transferred orally. So by virtue of this particular provision, we have covered not only the movable properties but also the immovable properties, the value of which are rupees 100 and less, which are less than rupees 100. Then in that case, definitely by mere delivery of the possession of that particular property, the property could be transferred from one person to the another. When we enter into such kind of a transfer, then in that case we call the same to be a oral transfer. Now there are other properties which need to be transferred by way of writing only, for the reason that there is a provision which has been provided for the registration of those transfers which are more than or which are having a value of property involved is more than 100 rupees. That is to say, whenever the immovable property, the value of which is more than 100 rupees, then in that case, that particular immovable property need to be transferred by way of entering into a writing instrument, and that too the registration of the said is the compulsory one. Immovable properties may be transferred orally having less than rupees 100 value by way of following ways we can transfer. Firstly, month-to-month tenancy, by mortgage by deposit of title deed, and third one is exchange of immovable property valuing less than rupees 100. So students, ये तीन basically तरीके की जो property है, या तीन तरीकों से हम immovable property को oral transfer के तहत transfer कर सकते हैं, जिसमें सबसे पहला है mouth to mouth tenancy. अगर हम create करते हैं तो वो हम oral transfer कर सकते हैं. Second, mortgage by deposit of title deed यदि हमने किया है तो वो भी हम oral ट्रांसफर के तहत प्रॉपर्टी ट्रांसफर कर सकते हैं. एंड थर्ड वन इज अगर हम इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी का एक्सचेंज डील कर रहे हैं, या एक्सचेंज हम कर रहे हैं इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी की, और इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी की जो वैल्यू है वो लेस देन रुपीज 100 है, देन इन दैट केस वहां पे भी हम क्या कर सकते हैं, बाय सिंपली एंटरिंग इन टू एन ओरल ट्रांसफर हम ट्रांसफर कर सकते हैं प्रॉपर्टी एक पर्सन से दूसरे पर्सन को. नेक्स्ट इज डिलीवरी ऑफ पोजेशन ओरल ट्रांसफर में इम्पॉर्टेंट है. तो ओरल ट्रांसफर में अनलेस एंड अनटिल ओरल ट्रांसफर कब कंप्लीट होता है, जब उसमें हम डिलीवरी ऑफ पोजेशन देते हैं. व्हेन एवर वी गिव अ डिलीवरी ऑफ द पोजेशन, देन ओनली इन दैट केस ओरल ट्रांसफर वुड कम टू एन एंड और वुड बी कंसिडर्ड टू हैव बीन कंप्लीटेड. तो प्रॉपर्टीज विच में बी ट्रांसफर्ड बाय डिलीवरी ऑफ पोजेशन ओनली, देन इन दैट केस वहां पे राइटिंग इज नॉट नेसेसरी. जनरली जितनी भी मूवेबल प्रॉपर्टीज होती हैं कैन बी ट्रांसफर्ड ओरली. थर्ड, इसमें एग्जाम्पल हम देख रहे हैं माउथ टू माउथ टेनेंसी, मॉर्गेज बाय डिपॉजिट ऑफ टाइटल डीड, एंड एक्सचेंज ऑफ इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टीज हैविंग लेस देन रुपीज 100 वैल्यू, देन इन दैट केस ऑल दीज प्रॉपर्टीज कुड बी ट्रांसफर्ड बाय वे ऑफ ओरल ट्रांसफर. नाउ लेट अस सी स्टूडेंट द प्रॉपर्टीज विच कैनॉट बी ट्रांसफर्ड ओरली बट नीड टू बी ट्रांसफर्ड बाय वे ऑफ एंटरिंग इन टू अ डॉक्यूमेंट इन राइटिंग और बाय एंटरिंग इन टू एन इंस्ट्रूमेंट इन राइटिंग. So the registration is compulsory for the following, or we would consider that where the writing is compulsory. So firstly, if we are dealing with a sale of an immovable property having more than value rupees 100, then in that case the immovable property would be transferred only by way of writing instrument, and over which the registration of that particular document would be compulsory. Next is simple mortgage. While creating a simple mortgage, there has to be a written document and also the registration of the said document. Next is exchange of immovable property exceeding rupees 100 value. So here, whenever suppose we are dealing with an exchange transaction of an immovable property, That is to say, I am exchanging my immovable property against any other movable property or an immovable property. Then in that case, the property, if suppose is having more than rupees 100 value, then in that case, the writing of that particular transaction is compulsory. Next is the sale of reversions right or other intangible property. Reversionary right means what? The right of the legal heirs. A part of that, if there is a other intangible property which are subject matter of the transfer, then in that case, the transaction would be entered into by way of writing, as well as the registration of said document would be necessary. Next is, if we are entering into a yearly lease, if we are entering into a yearly lease or a tenancy, then in that case also the writing of a transaction or writing down the transaction in writing is necessary. Then all the other mortgages except the mortgage by deposit of title deed. Students, you remember in our last lecture what we said, that the mortgage by deposit of the title deed would be done by way of oral transfer, and hence a part of this mortgage by deposit of title deed, all the other mortgages would be having a writing effect. That is to say, without transferring, without entering into a written document, all the other mortgages cannot be entered into, and hence the registration as well as the writing is necessary for all such kind of a mortgage. Now let us see where the registration is necessary for the following types of transaction. Students, in our earlier slide, we have seen the various other kind of, suppose for example, yearly lease, then mortgage, then a sale of reversions, then exchange of immovable property, the simple mortgage or a sale of immovable property exceeding 100 rupees value. Then in that case, all these kind of transaction need to be done in writing. Registration may be done or may not be done, but suppose if we take into consideration the sale of an immovable property exceeding rupees 100 value, then in those situations the registration would be compulsory. But nowadays in practice we see that simple mortgage, though may be entered into, or any other kind of mortgages except the mortgage by deposit of title deed, only the writing being done and the registration is not been compulsorily done by the people. Likewise, the lease which are based on yearly premium, then in that case, even those lease are simply done in writing and registration is not always seen in relation to those particular properties. Likewise, the gift of an immovable property is need to be done by way of entering into a writing instrument, as well as the registration of those documents would be considered to be compulsory. But when we talk about the transfer of an actionable claim, then in that case only writing is sufficient and registration of those documents are not necessary. Then if we take into the corresponding provisions which has been provided under Indian Registration Act 1908, then in that case we would find that the Indian Registration Act 1908 deals with the procedure for registration of the document and compulsory registrable transfers. That is to say, what are the procedure for registration of any kind of such a transaction, and what transactions or what is the subject matter of the suit wherein the registration of those document is compulsory. Next is, where writing and registration are essential requirement to constitute a transfer, the property cannot be transferred in any other way. Students, this is very important, that whenever any kind of transaction need to be done in writing has been provided by the law, then in that case, only for the purposes of making that particular transaction to be valid, it is essential that all the requirement to constitute that particular transfer, including the transfer to be made in writing, is compulsory. The transfer of the property in any other manner will be termed to be an invalid transfer. So I hope, student, you have understood the concept of oral transfer, and the provision of section 9 specifically deals with the oral transfer. I hope you have understood the concept. Thank you very much.